Hi friends, welcome back. Today we are going to solve LeetCode problem 1962, remove stones to minimize the total. So let's go through the description. You are given a zero indexed integer array piles where piles of I represents number of stones in the ith pile and an integer k. You should apply the following operation exactly k times. Choose any piles of I and remove floor of piles of I divided by 2 stones from it, right? So if, for example, if piles of I value is 7, right, then we have to do 7 divided by 2, which is 3.5, right? And then we have to floor it. So it will be 3 basically. That's what floor means. Notice that you can apply the operation on the same pile more than once. Return the minimum possible total number of stones remaining after applying the k operation. So minimum possible total number of stones we have to return. Floor x is greatest integer that is smaller than or equal to x, rounds x down, right? So that's what I just explained. So they have given us these two examples and the constraints are there, like the piles dot length is between 1 to 10 raised to 5 and piles of I value can be between 1 to 10 raised to 4 and k is between 1 to 10 raised to 5, right? So all these values are pretty like big values, right? So so let's take the second example over here and we can discuss how we can solve this problem. So our goal is to minimize the total, right? And we are allowed to do this floor operation. So we can choose any pile from this array and then we can divide it by 2, right? And then floor that value. So so let's take this example first. So as you can see here, right? So what we will do is we will first choose the, like, let's just write down these values, right? So we are going to solve this problem using priority queue or max heap, right? So let's just write down these values here. So 4, 3, 6, 7. So these are the arrays values, right? And let's say this is our priority queue, right? Let's just say that this is our priority queue. We'll just call it PQ, right? Priority queue. So this is a max heap implementation of priority queue. So what we will do is we will first iterate through the array and we will keep all these values into priority queue, right? We will push, like, offer these values to the queue. Offer means we are adding to the queue. So priority queue, we are going to use a max heap implementation. So always maximum value will be on the top, right? Will be on the front. So as you can say, 7, then 6, then 4, and then 3, right? Then 4 and then 3. So what we will do is we are allowed to do k operations, right? So we will always pull the value from the priority queue. So we will get the largest value, right? So 7 will come out first. So now our k, let's say I am just writing k here. So k is equal to, now when k is equal to 0 in the beginning, now k is equal to 1, we will pull the first value out, right? So we got 7 out of the priority queue and we will apply the operation, right? So 7, like this operation we are going to apply, floor of piles of I divided by 2, right? So 7 divided by 2 is equal to 3.5, right? And we will do the floor. So floor is equal to 3, right, of that. So we will have to reduce the value of this pile by 3, right? So now this value will be gone from the queue and we will have to we will get 7 minus 3, which is 4. So we have to add new value into the priority queue, which is 4, right? So we will add this value 4 here, let's say, right? Because it's a priority queue. So now we will have 6, 4, 4, 3, right? Now our k, again we will take a second turn and we will do the operation again. So k will become 2. We will again pull out the next largest value, which is 6, and we will divide that value by 2, right? So 6 by 2 is equal to 3. So we will reduce that pile by 3, right? So 6 minus 3 is equal to 3. So 6 is gone now, and remaining value 3, we will again add it back to the queue, right? So now 3 will be added at the end because that is the lowest value, right? So now k is equal to 2 now, right? Now we will do the operation again. So k becomes 3. So we will pull the highest value from the queue again. So 4 will come out of the queue. So 4 divided by 2 is equal to 2, right? Is equal to 2. So we will have like this pile will be reduced by 4 minus 2 is equal to 2, right? So 2 we will have to add into the priority queue again, right? So now, as you can see, we are finished with our allowable operations, which were 3, right? So what we will do after we finish the operations, we will take out all the elements from the priority queue and we will sum them up, right? So if you sum them up all these elements, then how much it will be? 4 plus 3 plus 3 plus 2, like 4 plus 3, 7 plus 3 is 10 and 10 plus 2 is 12, right? So 12 is our answer basically, right? So this is how we are going to minimize the total. So this is a greedy approach. We are going to take the pile which is the highest stones values, right? So that is how that will be beneficial for us, because that will give us the maximum that will help us to minimize the total, right? Because we can reduce that maximum pile to half, right? Kind of thing. So that's why always we will greedily choose the highest value. And to choose the highest value, the best data structures in Java is priority queue. We are going to use max heap implementation. So we will provide a comparator lambda expression when we will create priority queue in such a way that always the maximum element will be on the top of the priority queue, right? So this is the way we are going to solve this problem. This is another example, just in case I just thought I wanted to explain. So in this case, you know, you can see the 20 is the maximum value, right? So first value will be reduced by like k is equal to 2, right? In this case, so first value 20 we will reduce by half, so it becomes 10, right? And in the next time, like, because we have 2 turns allowed, right? So next time we will allowed like we will take 18, which will be reduced by 9, right? So if you calculate all these other values, like this 30 plus 10, 40 plus 10, 50 and 59, right? So 59 will be our answer for this one, right? 59 will be our minimized total value, right, after the operations. So we will take this also in our test case for our testing. So let's look at the implementation quickly. So first I created a integer sum variable, right, and it is in assigned to 0, and then I created a priority queue here of integer, right, because we want to hold integers. And then I have created a lambda expression here because we want to maximum heap, right? So we will say b minus a, so maximum value will be on the top in that case. After that, we will iterate through all the piles and we will offer like add all the piles value into the priority queue, right? And after that, I created a t variable is equal to 0 because we want to make that operation k number of times, right? So for to hold the value of how many times we have done that operation, I created a t variable that we will use in while loop. So we will always fall the value from the priority queue, means we are removing the highest element always, right? See, then we will use that operation. This operation is this operation, right? This floor of piles I divided by 2. So this operation we are implemented here using math.floor div c divided by 2, right? And then we will get r value. So we will just subtract r from c, right? And then we will again put that remaining value into the queue, correct? For example, here when we got like 7 divided by 2 floor value 3, we will reduce that value, right? 7 minus 3 and put it back into the queue, right? So that's what we are doing basically here. And then we will increment the t counter, right? So we will do it until t is less than k. After we are done, so we will do, let's say for example, in this case, we will do that operation 3 times, right? So that's what we are doing in this while loop. So after we are done with that operation, we will just iterate through the priority queue and we will sum the elements, right? As I said, these elements, these remaining elements in the priority queue, now we have to sum it and we will just return that sum, right? So that is how we have implemented this problem. So this is the test case that we just talked about, this one. So the answer should be 59 here. K is given as a 2, right? So let's just run our code quickly. So we get correct answer, right? 59 we got answer here. So we will take a couple of other test cases also here. So let's take this test case. K is equal to 3 in this case. So 12 should be the answer here. So we are getting 12, which is correct answer here. So we will just take the first one also, and K is equal to 2, so we should get 12 here. So we are getting correct answer, right? So we can just go ahead and submit our solution here. So our solution got accepted. So it passed all the 59 test cases, and it is almost 70% faster than other submissions, and almost 78% better in memory, right? So which is pretty good. So this is how we can solve this problem of removing stones to minimize the total using the greedy approach, and we use the priority queue, the max heap implementation, right, to hold the maximum values always on the top. So if you haven't already looked into my playlist of LeetCode and LeanCode solutions on my channel, please check it now. It has more than 100 solved problems which were asked by previously big tech companies like Amazon, Apple, Microsoft, Google, Facebook, and lot of many other companies. So those were coding questions that were previously asked in their interviews. So those were explained with examples and details and Java code. So please check it out. Also, those were handpicked problems, you know, to cover a different variety of problems that includes dynamic programming, linked list related problems, string related interview questions, then breadth first search, depth first search like BFS, DFS, then, you know, like a binary search trees, then graph related problems. So please check it out. It will definitely help you in your interview preparation. Also, there is another playlist called as Java interview. If you are preparing for Java telephonic interviews or you know, initial screening interviews, it has a lot of problems that were previously asked and frequently asked questions. So please go through them. If you like this video and if you find this video helpful, please subscribe to the channel and like the video. Thanks for watching the video.